Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video I'm going to talk about wound ballistics. So as we all know that the subdivisions of ballistics are of three types: internal ballistics, external ballistic and terminal ballistic. Out of these, internal ballistic talks about whatever is happening inside the firearm, which starts right from the trigger pull and until the bullet reaches the muzzle end of the barrel. Then comes external ballistics. External ballistics talks about whatever happens after the bullet goes out from the muzzle end. So then we talk about terminal ballistics. Now terminal ballistics is a subdivision of ballistics which starts whenever the bullet reaches the target and it hits the target. So terminal ballistics is also known as wound ballistics. It is called wound ballistics because once the target hits any living object, for example human beings or any other animal, a wound is formed. Hence terminal ballistics is also known as wound ballistics. Terminal ballistics deals with the behavior of the missile once it reaches the target. Now one thing important for entrance point of view is that the minimum velocity that is required in order for the projectile to penetrate the skin is 40 to 50 meter per second, whereas in order to penetrate bone it is 60 meter per second. Next, let's talk about how the wound is formed. So as we all know that the bullet is moving with a certain energy which is called the kinetic energy, that is half mv square. Kinetic energy, we all know this formula, right? So you can see here that kinetic energy is depending upon the mass of the bullet and it is depending upon the velocity of the bullet. So mass, kinetic energy, as you can see, is directly proportional to the mass, whereas it is directly proportional to velocity also, but the square of velocity. So if the mass is more, kinetic energy is going to more, but if velocity is more, kinetic energy is going to be even more because of this square value over here. So the bullet, when passing through the human tissue, will consume some or all of its kinetic energy to the surrounding tissue. Now as soon as the bullet hits the target, it is going to transfer its kinetic energy to the target area, resulting in throwing the tissue away from the bullet part, due to which what happens is that this tissue area is thrown away like this in a radial manner, leaving a temporary wound cavity. So due to hitting of the projectile into the target, there is a cavity formation that occurs. Now this cavity can be of two type. It can either be temporary or it can be permanent. Alright, so the cavity that is temporary, this is formed due to the natural elasticity of the human tissue. Now human tissue is not stiff, they will not burst open or something. It since they are elastic, they're going to displace from their place and then they will be regaining their original structure because of their elastic nature. So the temporary nature of this cavity, we are talking about the temporary cavity, results from the natural elasticity of the human skin, which regains its original structure after the bullet has passed. So look here in this picture, this entire cavity is the temporary cavity. Then there's another cavity called permanent cavity also. This permanent cavity, this much area is the permanent cavity over here. Alright, so this much is the permanent cavity. So there's also a permanent cavity resulting from the destruction of tissue caused by the bullet itself. So as I told that the temporary cavity is caused due to the elastic nature of the firearm because the bullet has transferred its kinetic energy to the tissue. But in case of permanent cavity, this permanent cavity is caused due to the bullet itself. because it is basically the path that has been formed by the bullet itself. The permanent cavity, it depends upon the cross-sectional area of the bullet. Now the dimensions of the permanent cavity is going to be dependent upon the cross-sectional area of the bullet itself and any secondary missile produced. Now the bullet is the primary missile, but in some cases secondary missiles are also formed. Secondary missiles are formed due to the breaking of bullet. Sometimes when the bullet hit a particular target, it breaks down, which leads to production of secondary missiles. Now this permanent cavity can also be formed due to the secondary missile produced due to breakup of the bullet during its passage. So I hope you have understood the reason permanent cavity is formed and the reason temporary cavity is formed and how they are formed. Now let's understand the differences between them. The temporary cavity has a very short lifespan. Now since temporary cavity is formed due to elastic nature of the tissue, so it is of very short lifespan. Why short? Because as soon as the skin is forming the cavity, it tries to regain its normal position also. It tries to come back to its normal position. So that is why the lifespan of temporary cavity is very short, as the name is indicating that is temporary, and is followed by a number of aftershocks decreasing in severity. Then there's another cavity, that is permanent cavity. It may be many times greater than the diameter of the missile, but is also many times smaller than the permanent cavity. Now as I told, that permanent cavity depends upon the cross-sectional area of the bullet, right? Now the dimensions of the permanent cavity can either be equal to or it can either be greater than the bullet cross-sectional area, but it can never be smaller than the cross-sectional area of bullet. But it is always smaller than the temporary bullet. The diameter of the permanent cavity is always smaller than the diameter of the temporary cavity. Unlike the temporary cavity, where the tissue is merely being thrown away from the wound track and no permanent damage is being caused to the tissue. So in temporary cavity, there is no permanent damage, because the tissue is just being thrown away. It's just simply thrown away, which will come back to its original position. But in case of permanent cavity, this is permanent in case, and there is no coming back to the original position, and hence the damage that is caused is much more. So this was all about this video. I hope you understood the types of cavities, permanent cavity and temporary cavity, and how are they formed. I'll be discussing more about wound ballistics in my upcoming videos. So stay tuned to my channel. Thank you.